The Forbidden City, the palace complex nesting in the heart of Beijing, is a very crowded place. It's often packed with people all over the globe who are desperate to set their eyes on the historic structures and relics safeguarded within. Being a local, I have the privilege of visiting the place very often. The last time was in early July during the Chinese school holiday. I went there with some of my friends, and, as expected, the entire area was jammed with overly zealous visitors. There were long queues at the waiting area, and transport getting in and out was very difficult. What made things worse was the scorching weather, which got me close to losing my patience. If we had chosen to visit on a day between November and March during the off-season, we could have done everything in our itinerary. For instance, walk leisurely from one building to another, go off the beaten path, and explore the ancient alleys and secret passageways around the complex that were excluded from the audio guide. Well, it was too late. We were there during a peak season, so we had no choice but to squeeze in and elbow our way from the Meridian Gate on the south to the Gate of Divine Might on the north. We didn't even get the chance to glimpse the huge collection of fancy imperial clocks, since every corner of the complex was packed with tourists. I often wonder why people endure the inconvenience of visiting a place that they know will be crowded. Perhaps the multitude of them flooding a limited space creates a festive atmosphere that adds to the spectacle.